This is a true saying.
And Paul didn't preach. He opened up your eyes. He didn't preach now about no women in the pulpit.
Amen.
Are you listening to what I'm saying? Some people get angry at me because they say, look, you, who's you to judge? I'm not judging. The Word of God got us. That's what's going to judge us. Amen. Jesus said himself, I came not to judge, but the word that I speak unto you, that's what's going to judge you. And God wants his word preached to the people right now. Amen. Amen. That's how he bring you out of darkness into light. Read it, brother.
This is a true saying.
This is a true saying.
If a man,
M-A-N, not one man,
desire the office.
You better hear me out there on the YouTube there and the internet. You know a lot of you got no women in there preaching to you. You can't tell you won't say that she's not of God. Oh, that's a godly woman. Oh, yes. If she was so much of God and really repented, God would open up her understanding and let her know that she's wrong in what she's doing.
Amen.
Are you listening to what I'm saying?
Yes.
Why God can't show? Because you got the wrong spirit there. That's right, the wrong spirit. See, demon spirits in these people. Mm-hmm. The demon spirit have people saying all kind of things, believing all kind of old lies and old filthy things. So something inside of them is not right.
Amen.
All right, this is what I'm saying. You go and see this. I see the other. I say the other. You see everything but God.
Amen.
Because of that demon spirit that's in you. See, so many of those demon spirits can get into a person. Not just one. They'll have a whole legion of them.
Yes.
Amen. Read.
If a man desire the office of a bishop.
If a man desire the office of a bishop.
He desireth a good work.
Not sheep. He desires a good work. And you got women on the earth here today saying they're a child of God and calling themselves a bishop.
Amen. That's right.
So the right here from the church here. This better say, I won't say born in here, but just raised up in here. Sing on the choir. Shout all over around the place. Shout so to you, shout out of a slip. Amen.
Amen.
And if she still slip fall off, she be still shot. It's going on. And her uncle came over to her one day and said, No, wait, look, you know it ain't all in that now. You put your slip back on there. You tell him this lesson to the line.
Amen.
More than once it happened. She should have known this slip come off, put up 10, tighten it up more tighter.
Yeah.
No,
Yeah.
A little holler right in the church, demonstrate.
Amen.
And shouting all over the place. And call yourself a bishop today in a church. I said, shame on you. I just hope the Lord that you can get this YouTube. But that wouldn't mean nothing because that demon, you got a demon spirit in you, can't tell you women preachers nothing. Y'all don't believe the word of God.
Amen.
No. Y'all think that everything here, what it said, go for you. Do you? You think God's speaking to a woman yet about the office of a bishop? Read, my brother.
Verse 2. A bishop then must be blameless.
A bishop then must be blameless. Now, if somebody reading this here and looking at it with your heart, you see, you have no place in the pulpit, woman. Read.
The husband of one wife.
Not the wife of one husband. The husband of one wife.
Amen.
Vigilant.
Yeah.
Sober.
Of
good behavior.
Uh-huh.
Given to hospitality.
Yeah.
Apt to teach.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Not given to wine. No striker. Not greedy or filthy lucre.
Don't love that money, because once you're the greedy or filthy lucre, you'll do anything.
Yes.
See, when you love money, I want to say the love of money is the root of all evil. Not money the root of all evil, the love of it. When a person loves money, he'll do anything for it. That's right. Your cat and mother killed for money.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Enough money comes in flash before his eyes, he'll do anything if you love it. That goes for the preacher too. And tell the preacher, you can be truly sent by God. But if you love money, God tell you, say, don't be a lover of it. Don't love it. Don't go and do anything for it to get that money. But you got some greedy dogs out here.
Yes.
And God can't use a greedy dog.
Nope.
So you tell the preacher, these are the qualifications that he has to have. Read it, brother.
But patient, not a brawler.
Not a brawler.
Not
people that have something put on them so they can get that blessing. They want to, you got to preach to them, gain is God. And God said, gain is not God. Is anybody preaching that to you? Say, withdraw yourself from, move away.
Amen.
Not just tell you there, man, teaching you gain is God.
Amen.
Get your hat and leave. Walk in and see a woman on the pool, in the pulpit, just turn around. It's the wrong church. I don't care how much you have holiness on the outside. I'm not looking at holiness when I walk in here. Read.
We're reading from 1 Timothy, the 3rd chapter. We are now at verse 4. One that ruleth well his own house.
Yeah, so the qualification. He have children there. He should rule well his own house. He should have all the children in check too.
Amen.
Amen. You tell them to look, if you don't want to obey the rules in here, hit that door.
Amen.
Amen. You want to obey the rules in here. You can be having nobody coming in here all the time at night and stuff coming in and bringing you home.
Amen.
What do you look for the sister to do?
Wait on the law.
Amen.
Keep it holy. Keep your home holy. Don't be like some people that go to church and know they left their daughter and the boyfriend there. Now, y'all behave. Y'all got the house tied. Get me going. I'm going to church now. Y'all hold the house down till I get back.
Amen.
All right, this is what I'm saying. Going to church, not children. Y'all just hold everything down till I get back. They hold it down until you get back, too. All right, this is what I'm saying.
Amen.
Hallelujah to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, yes.
All right. Read, my brother.
One that ruleth well his own house.
One that ruleth well his own home house.
Having his children in subjection with all gravity.
That means subjection. Don't care how they get angry and what the people say about sit to them outside.
Amen.
Oh, your father, he's a fanatic. He don't like to be out no later than 8 o'clock. Oh, come on. My father said, I can be out at 10. 1 o'clock, it don't make no difference with him.
Amen.
No, it don't make no difference with him because he's more likely to be out there at 3 coming in.
Mm.
All right, this is what I'm saying.
Amen.
Hallelujah to God. Read.
Verse 5. For if a man know not how to rule his own house,
if he don't know how to rule his own house,
how shall he take care of the church of God?
You see? You see how the preacher is like a father in the church?
Amen.
He sees something wrong, he corrects it.
Amen.
If you see a child, a daughter doing wrong, a son doing wrong, he corrects it.
Amen.
And not all that time, he may rebuke him. Sometimes sharply.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
So sharp. Yeah, sharp. How about Paul said, you want me to come to you in sharpness? All right, listen to what I'm saying.
Amen.
Amen. You see somebody want to be hard-headed in this young man here, you should say, hey, get a hold of yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to go to heaven or not?
Amen.
Or not? You have to be willing to be patient and endure on chastisement. God dishes out to us. We have to have chastisement right down here in this world here. That go for the pulpit, all the way back. That go for the president to the dog catcher.
Amen.
Amen. Read, my brother.
Verse 6. Not a novice.
Not a novice.
Lest being lifted up with pride, he fall into the condemnation of the devil.
That's right. Don't get so lifted up now, preachers. You got a lot of pastors and so-called elders and whatever. If you don't call them elders so-and-so, they'd be offended. If you don't say bishop so-and-so, he get offended. If you say brother so-and-so, I'm not no brother. I'm bishop so-and-so to you. Watch out, pride, man. You call me elder. Amen. You call me bishop. Amen. You call me T-O-M Tom. How you doing? Don't make no difference. No different than me. Don't make no difference. Lord knows I'm telling the truth. No different. Amen.
Amen.
Just remember to call me for dinner. Amen. Read.
We're reading from 1 Timothy, the 3rd chapter. We're now at verse 7.
Amen.
Moreover, he must have a good report of them which are without, lest he fall into reproach and the snare of the devil.
Must have a good report. You can't have someone say, who you got casting you? William Furse. William. I saw him coming out of the blue room so and so last night. Oh, I saw him doing so and so. I saw him taking a drink. I saw him doing this. You gotta have a good report out there. And he can't lay a finger on
verse 8. Likewise,
listen to this.
Must the deacons be grave?
The deacons, and you got women call themselves deacons now.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
If the husband be made a deacon, so the wife should become the deaconess. These people need to be ashamed of yourself. You're ridiculous. Husband is a deacon, but I'm the deaconess. So, okay, all the deaconesses, lady came out here one day, talking about, now, if you're going to have a program, we put a leaflet on your door because all of us are our deaconesses, you know, we having some program. I said, miss, I know I may not see her again, I had to tell her. I said, miss, no. I said, matter of fact, where is any women deacon will find in the Bible? Where is deaconess will find in the Bible? Well, now, the deacon, I said, yeah.